So you know that we have brought in the connection. The very second step is to establish one research question for this particular theme. See, this is the general meaning which is according to the theory, and this is what I've connected with the theory, right? So now you establish one research question. You put research question one, and you can type, will a greed behavior make the situation better? That is a research question. Second research question. Research question two. Greed behavior to make the situation better. Is there humanity in this approach? So I'm raising two research questions here for my research study. You might ask me a question, how many research questions should I come across with? There is no such type of limitations. So usually if you come across with research questions, it would look good. So for this particular connection, we have two research questions. Now I'll do the third one. You can look into it. So I'm taking the theory here, and I'm going to introspect on the theory. I'm reading it again. So there's something interesting. So greed behavior is also an example for horizontal inequality. That is what this theory is telling. So I'm reading, what do you mean by horizontal inequality? It tells that it brings in a lot of inequality, which means if a person is greedy, that person would consume a lot, and he would ensure that the other part of the society might not get that portion. So equal distribution will not be there. So that is what this horizontal inequality is mentioning. So even more in depth, I would like to know about the horizontal inequality. So I'm opening that page also, and I would like to know what that particular concept is about. So it talks about, it's a forced inequality between different subcultures living in the society, which means I'm a rich person, only I might make use of the benefit. So that is what the rich and the poor. So only one part of the society makes use of this. And you can also tell that horizontal measures of inequality differs from standard vertical methods of measuring inequality in several ways. That is what has been mentioned here. It talks about economic level. It talks about the household differences. It talks about the cultural factors. It talks about multidimensional thing. So I'm going to use that term. So I'm going to continue again here only. I'm going to continue. You put your cursor here only and you start. Greed behavior has its roots from an approach known as horizontal inequality. And the same can be applied for the purchase situation during the COVID-19, because only one part of the society is able to make comfortable purchase, and the other part of the society is neglected. In this regard,